Since the beginning, the L Word has inspired much buzz over the ever-elusive topic of lesbian fashion. And a glamorous second season will make heads turn.
Prada and Escada,
Dolce & Gabbana, Gucci,
Valentino,
Etro. We've been lucky because we were so popular in the first season that these designers have come forward and said, you know, hey, can we be on your show?
There's a commitment to having the show feel luscious.
There's been a whole lot of play given to this notion of lesbian fashion in the last year. It wasn't a hard choice to go full out and high-end with the fashion.
All right, so this is Bette's closet.
This is Stella McCartney, and we've been dressing her a lot in Stella this season.
Most of the wardrobe was pretty classic.
This is also something we ventured into a lot with Jennifer this season, is a little bit of the lace underneath.
It's sort of like a fairy meets Zelda Fitzgerald in Paris. Like, that's how I would describe Jenny, the way Jenny's dresses.
I have so much say in what she wears.
This season we're doing a little bit more of a strokes meets Patti Page kind of look.
With like more layers and more colors and a tie and beat up t-shirts and blazers.
My style gets way better. It's more colorful, it's more flashy. I think before it was like, does Alice mismatch? Is she like a fashion crisis? But no, she's a happening chick. She's got to look good.
Shane and Jenny still can't make the rent, but they can have beautiful outfits.
But you know, it's TV. It's called fantasy.
So what if you break a mold? So what if you're not like showing a stereotypical idea of what a lesbian looks like? I mean, to me, it's refreshing.
At a core level, I do believe that the show is being representative of our characters as lesbians in the LA community.
I've learned so much about fashion from these women. It blows my mind. I thought I had style before. No idea. And I don't think I do still.
The resources that have thrown behind us are definitely improved, and we're taking great advantage of them, from fashion to music.
So I want you to give it up for Betty!
We've all been sort of throwing in our two cents, giving CDs to Eileen.
I think I put Phoenix on there. Luna.
Peaches.
Iggy Pop.
Nina Simone. We're thinking about PJ Harvey, but, you know, we're still doing it, so we'll see.
Going from groundbreaking to trendsetting doesn't stop with the wardrobe and music.
Step right up, ladies and gentlemen!
A-list guest stars turn out shining performances, and the show continues the tradition of working with indie cinema's finest directors.
What I look for in directors is filmmakers whose work has moved me.
The roster of directors we've had this year is, it's like mind-blowing.
Lynn, who directed Kissed, which was all the rage at Sundance a number of years ago.
Bruce Dears, who directed It Goes Down.
Lisa Chaladenko, who directed High Art and Laurel Canyon.
Ernest Dickerson was, you know, Spike Lee's DP for 20 years, and now he's making movies on his own. And
this is the first show that I've ever been on where the producers have scheduled director-actor meetings with every single key cast member. This is highly unusual because actors are not usually available for this, but they insist.
It's really important because if you haven't worked with them yet, it gives you a chance to see where each person's coming from.
I think that certain directors have their takes on our characters, but the fact is we know our characters probably better than anybody else at this point. If you're having script problems, you can sort of flesh that out in the director's meeting.
But you also, like, have to trust that they have something completely new and exciting to say about it.
I know it's a really good episode when I'm getting the knocks on the door saying, so do you think we can talk about that scene, like, before we start shooting?
We see experience through a lot of different prisms, and it's really fun to invite all of these filmmakers in to interpret the experiences of our characters.
The most interesting thing about doing this show is that it's an entirely female show. The producers are women, the writers are women. Many of the directors are women. The entire cast is women, except for one or two exceptions. It's not like doing other shows, I'm finding. It's completely non-hierarchical, which is very interesting.
Some of the scenes just come out in some improvisation, which is wonderful for all of us.
It's just not paint by numbers here. You know, this is really demanding a lot from the people who work on the show.
And that's them really watching out for their characters and really considering the audience.
I come in with a whip and a bullhorn. Make sure they do it right.
Those girls are crazy. The way they've become friends is really similar, actually, to the characters that they play.
As gifted as each of these actors is individually, working together, they become something much more intriguing.
It's like being at a pajama party sometimes. you know, being a traffic cop at a pajama party. I don't know if that's a good analogy.
You can really get the sense that everybody's involved in moving the story forward in the greater good.
From breakups to breakdowns, hookups to just plain hooks, deliveries to deliverance, season two of The L Word will keep the pages of TV history turning.
People have become invested in the show, and they've asked us for things, and I want our audience to feel served.
I'm not worried about any kind of sophomore slump or anything, because I just sort of feel like we still have a lot more stories to tell.
We're doing great. Yeah. Great.
I think the show is much braver, more daring, less expository in terms of what it is to be gay or what it is to be a lesbian, because at the end of the day, how can you define that?
You just want to sleep with people, make them fall in love with you.
Season two is much more involved with the details of relationships rather than the tackling of concepts or ideas.
I hope you had fun blowing off some steam with the carpenter.
You know, it assumes that we're dealing with smart, thinking viewers, you know, not just people who want to be spoon-fed.
Did I underestimate you, Shane?
I think you mistook me for one of your little tricks.
It's the romp, it's the ride, it's the energy.
Are you even gay, Melissa?
You have to watch season two. You should watch The L Word.
You should definitely tune in for second season.
At your own peril. Who knows what's going to happen?
It's super fun.
And there's great clothes.
I heard a rumor that hair might grow on your palms if you don't.
Because all of your questions will hopefully be answered.
Which one would you rather put in your mouth, though?
God willing, in the order they were received.
The L Word, premiering Sunday, February 20th at 10 p.m., 9 central.
But don't I look like sort of the dominant one?
Oh, yeah.
You're sure. You're sure.
You're sure.
Yeah, you're
worse couple. What about us, too?
What about us?
Yeah, you guys make
it.
See, great
we're
couple.
The favorite. We're the favorite.
Terrible.
Oh,
terrible.
Okay, wait, you two get together. How about us? No. 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 Okay, what about us? Wait, what about us?
That's terrible.
You guys make. Oh, I think it's.
What do you think?
I want to make a good couple with somebody.
You know in your heart you and I are good.
How about us?
No,
absolutely.
Oh, no, I think
we're so feminine. We're like, what?
Look. You guys, look at our faces.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
It doesn't work.
No.
It doesn't.
I love this sexual dynamic between you.